feels like I've been down to the river. You washed away all my shame. No longer bound because I'm forgiven, yeah. I've been made free from sin's guilty stain. You gave your life for me that I might be saved. You changed my destiny with the awesome price you paid. Now I can say, old things are passed away, all things are new.
I'm not the same.
Yes, I've been changed.
Yes, I've been changed.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, it's true.
It's true.
I found my life in you.
All things are new. The same.
Yes, I've been changed.
Yes, I've been changed.
Yeah.
Changed.
Mind's renewed, no longer a sinner. No greater love have I ever known. No. And now I've got power to walk like a winner. Though I may fail, he still calls me his own. You gave your life for me that I might be saved, yeah. And you changed my destiny with the awesome price you paid. Now I can say,
all things are passed away.
All things are new.
All things are new. I'm not the same.
Yes, I've been changed.
Yes.
Yeah,
yeah,
it's true, it's true,
it's true.
I found my life in you.
All things are new. I'm not the same.
Yes, I've been changed.
Yes, I've been changed.
Yeah.
Have you ever met any man which has retired from civil service, for instance, before embarking on professional footballing? That is, he's retired now at the age of 55, and he said, what do you want to do? He said, I want to become a professional footballer. That is past. The season for his stardom in professional football is over. It is impossible for him to be enlisted, talk less of imagine his time. Have you ever met a professor who has just retired from his university and is now out to enlist as a professional athlete to run 100 meters race or run 800 meters race? Is late. The season for enlistment is past. I'd like you to listen very carefully, because Paul the apostle calls it a race, and he also calls it as it were a wrestling. So fight I, not as one beat in the air or boxing. These are not things you can enlist in after certain season in your life. You are no longer eligible for enlistment after a particular season of your life. There is a season for enlistment. When you miss that season, like an old English adage, once an opportunity once lost can never be what? Regained. An enlistment season once lost can never be regained. Listen to me very carefully. I want to start you from this natural perspective before we go into scriptures. At a particular season in your life, you are no longer considered fit for enlistment in the race. You are no longer considered fit for enlistment in the race of destiny. You just begin to survive. The best you can do is make a living. You can't make an impact. There are multitudes in the world just making a living. There are few making an impact. They are the ones they call stars. This is very important. Almost every celebrity in the race of life got to know where they belong on time, and they stuck there. Almost every celebrity in the race of life knows where they belong on time, and they stuck there. They know where they belong, and they stuck there. In the field of sports, no one ever gets late, gets up late, and becomes a star. You never find a sports star that got started even at 30. So you can see time is running out. Timely discovery for striking accomplishment.
There are a few things you just can't learn from a textbook that you have to live through, to see, to be fully entrenched in, because here is a simple truth. This world is a tough place. Getting what you want, making the most of the time you have, requires that you put yourself in the position to succeed. It means you see a finish line before one exists. Look, no one's ever going to call you and tell you how incredible your idea is. You can't build a business on potential or win a championship on promise. Results are binary. You either accomplished something or you simply did not. Right? That's it. That's what people see, the result. So that means every second, every step of the way from where you are right now until you cross the finish line depends on you and your thoughts. how you internalize failure, how you look at setbacks, when no one is around to pat you on the back or tell you how great you are, will you have enough self-belief to move forward? Because my friends, that's the hardest part. That's what no one talks about. Having the courage to wake up every single day of your life and know that you are building towards something incredible. You are creating a masterpiece from the ground up. And that means that when you're looking in the mirror, you believe in what's staring back at you. You see the unseen and you are willing to bring it to life. That is the foundation that you build greatness on. And it's a daily pursuit, creating milestones, designing the small wins that keep you going, that keep you moving, that get you past all those times you so desperately want to turn around, but know that for you, it simply isn't an option. That is not your reality. You have more waiting for you. And so you press on, cloaked in confidence, you move into the unknown, seeking the day the rest of the world looks up and calls you lucky. They'll look at what you built and say how fortunate you are, but they won't comprehend the 20-hour days, the focus, the ridicule for being different or obsessive or nonconformist. They won't know that self-belief trumped all of that. That it was everything. The word great is separate for a reason. It implies a specific set of beliefs and values. It means you saw light when most people saw darkness. It means you said yes when most people said no. You moved forward when the rest of the world turned around. Believe in your greatness. See it, live it. It is there and you need to know that it's there. Because it will make all the difference. Your self-belief will define you.
Like I've been down to the river. You washed away all my shame. No longer bound because I'm forgiven, yeah.